Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to create a PDF document using the Syncfusion PDF Library. The PDF Library allows you to create, read, and edit PDF documents. It also offers functionalities to merge, split, and secure PDF files, and convert Word, RTF, Excel, and HTML files to PDF. In this tutorial, I will show you how to create a .NET console application in Visual Studio and add the Syncfusion PDF library to it. I will also demonstrate how to create a simple PDF document with text, image, and table. Now, let's start to create a console app. I open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project. From the list of project templates, I select the console app and name the project Invoice PDF Sample. Then, I continue with the default target framework and click Create button. Now, my application is ready to use, and let me start to create a PDF document. As a first step, I need to add the PDF library by installing the Syncfusion PDF NET Core NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet Package Manager. In the Browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion PDF NET Core NuGet package and install it in my application. The package is installed successfully. Here, I need to register the valid trial license key. Within this program.cs file, I register the trial license key using the register license method. To know where to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description. Look at this PDF document with text, image, and table. I am going to create a similar PDF document using Syncfusion PDF Library. I include the Syncfusion PDF library namespace to create a PDF document. Then, I initialize a PDF document class instance to create a PDF document and include a page to add the content. I get the size of the added page by excluding the page margins. The Syncfusion drawing namespace is imported automatically while using the sizef class. To draw each element in the PDF page, I need to specify its position in X and Y coordinates, and this size will be used later to calculate the element's position in the document. Next, I retrieve the image location and read it as a file stream from the specified location. Then include the PDF graphics namespace to create the image instance. To read the image stream data, I create a PDF bitmap instance using the FileStream object. I need to define a size to draw an image in the PDF document. Then, I set the image position, which will be used for the image when drawing. After that, get the graphics instance of the page using which the image can be drawn. Using Draw Image API, I draw the image at the specified position. After the image is drawn, let me proceed to add the text. But before that, let me define a standard font with name, size, and style for the text. Next, I create a text element along with its font and color properties. and define the string format to align the text content. I draw the text in the current page by calculating the x-coordinate based on the page width and y-coordinate based on the y-coordinate of the image. PDF layout result objects provide the rendered bounds for each and every elements added. It used to add successive elements and prevent content overlap. Similarly, I add a few more text to the document. And for each item, I calculated the position based on the previous item's position. So far, I have added an image and text to the PDF page. Now, let's see the output of this code by saving the document. To do this, I create a memory stream. And then call the save method, passing the stream as an argument. This will save the document to the stream. After saving the document, it is important to release the memory consumed by it, so I call the close method, which will dispose all the memory consumed by PDF. I pass true to the close method, which will also dispose its document stream. I then reset the memory stream position to start reading or writing data from the beginning. Save the document with the name output.pdf. Finally, I will run the application. Looking here, the PDF document is generated in the bin directory. I open this and you will find the added text and image. Okay, now let's proceed to add the remaining content. Now, let me show you how to add a table. Tables are referred as grids and can be created using the PDF grid instance. I import the namespace required for using the PDF grid. Then, create a new table. And define a standard font style. Now, I will assign the font style to the grid style to customize the grid. Here, I add four grid columns by calling the add method and setting the width value to 70 for second, third, and fourth columns. Next, I add a header row. And define a string format with horizontal and vertical alignment. Then, I will use this string format for the header row content. Next, I am going to add content to the cells in the header row. To achieve this, I obtain the header row instance. And set the text for the first cell using the value API. Then, align the content in the center of the cell using the line alignment property. Similarly, I add text to the remaining cells in the header row. After that, I add a new row to the grid that will be used to add the purchase item to its cells. And add content to its cells along with the text alignment. I have added content to the first three cells. Here, I am creating an invoice, so I add item information to the first three cells, and the fourth cell will contain the amount of each item purchased. To calculate the amount for each item, the product of price and quantity is taken. And the value is updated in the last cell. Also, the total amount for all the items should be specified at the end of the grid. So, here I create a variable called sum to calculate the total amount for all the items. Similarly, I add two more rows to the table. To customize the grid, I apply built-in style called grid table accent. Apart from this built-in style, I would like to add additional padding to cells to enhance the table appearance. So, I create a new PDF grid style. And initialize cell padding values for all the four sides. Here, assign this new style to the grid. Now, I will proceed to draw the table in the current PDF page. For that, I create a new layout format. And define its layout type. Then, draw the table with the created layout type and calculated position. Now I am going to draw a rectangle below the last column of the table to show the total amount, so let me specify its color and position and draw it using the graphics object. And finally, to display the total amount for all the items in the grid, create a text element and draw it. Then, show the total amount by rounding off the value in the sum. Therefore, I draw a new text element to show this total amount below the last column of the grid. I have finished adding content to the PDF document and now let me show you the final output. I open this output file. And you will see the newly added table with the total amount. Let me recap what I have shown so far. I showed you how to create a .NET console application in Visual Studio. I also showed you how to create a PDF document with text, image, and table using the PDF library. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our .NET products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.